For the last couple of weeks, we've been talking in great detail about what's coming to the Nintendo Switch based on some leaks and rumors regarding Mario's 35th anniversary. We talked about all the 3D Mario games, including 64, Sunshine, Super Mario Galaxy 1 and 2, and Super Mario 3D World. But today, we move on to a completely different type of Mario game that has also been leaked and rumored for a very long time. I'm talking about Paper Mario. We are continuing to get heavy leaks and rumors that are stating Paper Mario is coming this year as a return to form similar to Paper Mario 64 and the Thousand Year Door rather than the other three, which is very exciting and something that the fans have been asking for a long time. So today, we are talking about exactly what this game needs to be and what Paper Mario needs to do to go back to the original style and get everybody's hearts back where they were. We need an original location like Rogueport. No more Mushroom Kingdom. I want to see some creativity and uniqueness into our new location where we start off the game at. And even though Color Splash had a new area being Prism Island, it still came off as kind of a bootleg Rogueport and nothing really that original. The area wasn't as explorative as Rogueport and there really wasn't much to do, and it didn't really serve as anything but a place to take back paint stars. There was also no unique characters living in this town. It was just more Toads, so I guess it just felt even more generic because of that alone. I think the main villain should also go outside Bowser and give us another main threat that's pretty big and significant. I like to see those bosses that just make you think, wow, these guys are powerful. Look at the Thousand Year Door, for instance. Not only are you fighting an alienated species, but they are trying to awaken an ancient evil deep within the catacombs of Rogueport itself, the place you start the game at. So that is so exciting and something that changes up the way the story goes besides, yep, just Bowser again and his minions. Mario doesn't need any type of crazy gimmick, such as his 3D flip from Super Paper Mario, or even his paint hammer from Color Splash, or any type of stickers at all. Just no stickers. Anyways, Mario is pretty much just paper, and that's what he's good at being, paper. Let him be able to transform like he did with his paper plane and his boat and get real skinny, and those different type of abilities like he had in the Thousand Year Door. And if you haven't noticed yet, the Thousand Year Door is going to be pretty much the basis for what we serve this Paper Mario game on, because it was so good and it did everything so basically right. And that's all they need to do. Give Mario his paper aesthetics and his paper skills, and don't give him any type of crazy game-changing ability. Give us new types of side characters. We don't necessarily need new designs for characters, but bring back just the classic enemies that are dressed up and designed to look pretty cool. For instance, give them a hat and some different clothing, like the Goombas and the Shy Guys from 64 and the Thousand Year Door, and we should be good to go. This gives a character's personality, and every single character is a lot different than one another. And they don't look just like Toads that are ready to go. You know, Color Splash did this a little bit better by at least giving the Toads some personality by making some pirates and some explorers and stuff like that, but it still, at the end of the day, was all just Toads, and they still didn't match the unique personality of the Toads from Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. We also need different archetypes of enemies. Now, it's okay to have your occasional Goomba here and there, but come up with some creative designs for enemies, or also just bring enemies into the game that haven't been paperized yet that are part of the Mario franchise. A great example of this is Super Paper Mario. Yes, there's still some Goombas and Koopa Troopas, but man, there is a giant brand new set of enemies made just for Super Paper Mario that we've never seen before, and not even after this game at all. This is kind of just tied to Super Paper Mario, and there's enemies that are so wacky and so weirdly designed, it's just super creative in my eyes. Now, probably way up there and number one on many people's list is to have sidekicks return. This is a must. If you're going to return to form, this is what return to form means. They give the characters so much detail when they do this, and the story is so much more expanded with these extra characters. And not only that, but obviously the battle options are a lot more expanded as well. Instead of using gimmicks, you've got more side characters, which we'll get to in a second. Use enemies we haven't seen as side characters yet, such as, you know, a Chain Chomp, for instance, or maybe even a Charging Chuck. You don't need to necessarily have another Goomba or Koopa Troopa. Kind of switch things up, or maybe even create a brand new sidekick character that we've never even thought of before, like you did with Vivian. Something else that I think would be really cool is to be able to change your party leader on command. Similar to Super Paper Mario, you had Mario, Luigi, Peach, and Bowser, and they all had different mechanics. And on top of this, you would have different sidekicks with different party leaders, and you could really mix and match how your party looks, which could really help you in battle and make the combat a lot more deeper than usual. There needs to absolutely be zero powerful one-hit moves, just like the stickers and the thing cards. They are stupid. They make no sense, for one, because this is a Paper Mario game. This is about arts and crafts, and we're bringing in real-life objects. they just don't make sense. There's no reason to walk around beating a Goomba with a blender or a fridge. This is just stupid and it needs to go. It's perfectly fine to have regular power-ups or maybe even super power-ups, just like the Crystal Stars from the Thousand Year Door, but there's no reason to hit people with a fan. It's stupid and it's extremely OP. It might be one of the reasons why there was no leveling up system in the past couple of games, simply due to the fact because you could just wipe enemies out with these items, and bosses were incredibly easy and so were enemies, so there was really no reason or rhyme to level up whatsoever. You didn't need to level up your character when you had these stickers or thing cards to find, and they just need to completely do away with these things. I mean, seriously, if they return, I'm going to have a problem, Nintendo. The battle system should be as basic as ever. Basic is fun, Nintendo. We don't need crazy things to make the battle system fun. Leader abilities plus partner abilities is enough to give the player plenty of options. Like I said before, picking a leader could be very important. Maybe Mario's just an overall player with his hammer. Maybe Peach can pull up turnips and float a long time. I don't know. Bowser has fire, he's a heavy hitter. Luigi can use his vacuum cleaner. See, I'm just making things up as I go, and there's plenty of options there. On top of all your partners and their different types of abilities, maybe they can even team up and make unique attacks. There's plenty of stuff to do here. Just have basic attacks, maybe some items, and obviously your sidekicks, and things cannot go wrong. Whatever this new game turns out to be, please keep the graphic style similar to Color Splash, because if anything that game had right, it was the graphics. That game looked beautiful, probably one of the best looking games on the Nintendo Wii U. And it had that real arts and craft feel to it, similar to Yoshi's Crafted World, and it just felt right. It felt like that's what Paper Mario should be looking like this entire time. Everything was so perfectly hand-drawn and beautiful, man. If the Thousand Year Door looked like that, I think the Thousand Year Door could have possibly been one of the greatest video games of all time. This is such an amazing art style that they need to remember. This is a Paper Mario game after all, make it feel like paper. And I think that was the problem with 64, is it felt like an RPG, not necessarily a Paper Mario. And the Thousand Year Door did have some moments where it just didn't feel as papery as it should, and this game does it right. From the trees to the grass to the clouds in the background, everything looks so detailed. Along with the graphics, I really do hope the music continues to be the greatest part of Paper Mario games, because to me, it really is. It's one thing that stays consistent throughout all the Paper Mario games, if nothing else does, is the music. I've seriously found great tracks and tons of great tracks in every single Paper Mario game to date. Yes, even Sticker Star had great music. This series is known for its music, and it's just so dynamic depending on what level or stage you're on, and it just all comes together so great. So this needs to continue on. Nintendo, continue to pump out this great music, and everything will continue to go as planned. All in all, I just want to see Nintendo give the chance to make Paper Mario great again. Give it the opportunity to be good the way it used to. Listen to your fans and listen to what people have to say about how they feel of the recent Paper Mario games. Sticker Star just sucked, and Color Splash was still a lot better, and actually, a lot better than what people still give it credit for. Yes, it still had the gimmicks and personality of Sticker Star, but it still tried to step out and be its own thing. If Nintendo needs to go back and revisit some past Mario games and maybe even remake the original Paper Mario 64 or remake the Thousand Year Door, that's something that I would be up for. At least go back to your roots and find out what made Paper Mario great again, similar to how the Sonic franchise did for Sonic Mania. Go back and revisit what the heck made Paper Mario good. Or simply just listen to your fans, you know, that's always the easiest thing to do. There's something just so interesting and fun about having a unique area with unique cast of characters and side partners, and it just all comes together for a unique experience like never before. Paper Mario is something of a treasure that I think us Nintendo fans need to realize how important it is, and Nintendo themselves need to realize how important it is as well, and see what the fans have been asking for a very long time. So guys, once again, I leave it up to you. What do you think that Nintendo needs to do with Paper Mario? Are these the steps that are necessary to make this game good again? Or is there anything else that they need to add? Is there any type of characters or story elements that need to be changed, or even battle elements that you don't agree with or that you want to implement your opinion on? Let me know in the comments down below. And also, once again, feel free to join the official Nintendo Land Discord, where you can share your opinions with lots of the other members there as well. Also, get your name put at the very end of my videos for joining said Discord. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today, and like always, I will see you in the next one. See you guys.